just like in Vrindavan, there's Bhangirava, a big bark tree there. The same is here, in this place, Gosundwi. Therefore, Markandeya Rishi, he came and saw there Gosund, and Surabhi Gai, she gave him shelter and fed him, and there he worshipped Gauranga Mahaprabhu and received the darshan of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Next, we went to the Samadhi, the place of the Samadhi and the place of worship of Sri Thakur Bhaktivinoda. We heard about how he manifested the birthplace of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and also Navadvip Dham. Then we went to Sulana Vihar. In Satyuga, there was a king who was absorbed in material affairs even in his old age. But by another great good fortune, Sri Narada Muni came there and gave him instructions on Bhagavad Bhajan. He said, O King, you are so fortunate to live in this very dharam of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But it's a matter of great shame that you are still attached to wealth, wife and children, even in your old age. Wealth is of no value. It's very difficult to attain, difficult to maintain, and when you lose it, you cry. Therefore, it's no value because at the time of death, even one rupee you cannot take with you. And what you think is yours in the form of wife, children and wealth is factually not yours. And that even though you are attached to them, when you die and they burn you and they have a feast, they will forget all about you. Therefore, King, you should give up your attachment to useless things and develop your attachment for the freedom. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. By the instructions of Narada Muni, his eyes were opened and he performed Bhagavad Bhajan there in Satyuga and he had darshan of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. After the darshan disappeared, the king was weeping. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, do not worry, when I appear in Satyuga, you will also appear in my pastime. Therefore, king appeared as Bhulimanda Khan. He funded the second marriage of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And last we went to Devpali, or Nrsimhapali. After killing Hiranyakashipu, Bhagavan Nrsimhadev rested there. And that time all the devas, all the demigods came there and worshipped him. Therefore, that place is also known as Devpali. We also went to Harihara Chakra. Hari means the object of worship, Sri Hari. And Ha means the Seva, Seva Chakra, or Mahadev. After the battle with Ponga Vasudev and Krishna sent him to Sudarshan Chakra, which burned Varanasi to ashes. Therefore, Mahadev, he left Varanasi and went to Ekamrakanam in Bhubaneswar, where he worshipped the Zingaraj, that is in Jagannath Puri. But this Navadvip Dham is millions of times superior to even Kasi or Sri Jagannath Puri. Therefore, Mahadev left Jagannath Puri and took shelter here of this Navadvip Dham and performed one-pointed bhajan of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And finally, we went to Nrsimhapali. There we can remember the instructions of Sri Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj said, even from young age, from the age of 5, one should commence spiritual life. How? The first step. One should take shelter of the feet of a bona fide spiritual master, Sadhu Labdhava Nirasha, and one should offer everything one possesses to him. That spiritual master should be, have direct realization of Krishna, he should be expert in the scriptures, he also should be completely detached from any type of material enjoyment. Now we'll hear from Shidali Maharaj about the instructions of Sri Prahlad Maharaj.
Gurve Gaurashandraya Radhikaya Tralaye Krishmaya Krishnabhaktaya Karabhaktaya Namaha. I first of all offer my unlimited Dandavat Pranam as the lotus feet of my beloved Gurudev, Om Vishnu Pad Paramahamsa Parivaja Vacharya Astau Parivaja Shishima Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj. And the same again, I offer millions of Dandavat Pranam unto our beloved Nityadeva Parivaja Om Astau Parivaja Shishima Srila Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada. And all the Sharanji Sanyasi, John, and all the Vaishnavas and Vaishnavi devotees in the case of the Lord, Sandhana Pranam. So Srila Gurudev has instructed me to speak something of Prahlad Charita, which is the most inspiring topic for the practicing sadhak to emulate and follow the path of Sri Prahlad and witness his exemplary nishtha to Sri Krishna. Hiranyakashipu, his father, the great demon, who was served originally by the four Kumaras, Jayan Vijay, and to take birth as a demon, he manifested with a totally atheistic mentality. And he, in the womb of his wife, Tayalu, the brilliant Mahabhagavat Prahlad took his birth. And when Hiranyakashipu was performing his austerities with the endeavor to become immortal, at that time the demigods, they overran his kingdom and they captured Kayadu. And Kayadu was in the ashram of Narada Muni for 60,000 years in the shelter of Narada Muni. Narada Muni intervened when the demons when the demigods attacked the demon and gave shelter to Kayadu. And at that time, Narada Muni, he instructed fully all the Tattva and Siddhanta, the full understanding of the purpose and ultimate goal of life. So when Prahlad took his birth from Kayadu, then he was very nicely groomed by the Paka demons in the kingdom of Hiranyakashipu. And then one day, his father, he asked him, he had his mother, Kayalu, she dressed him very nicely, and he came into the assembly of Hiranyakashipu, and he sat on the lap of Hiranyakashipu. And Hiranyakashipu, with fatherly affection, he asked his son, what is the goal of life? What have you understood from your teacher? Then he replied, Satsalu manye sura vaya dehinam sada samudvigna diyam asatrahat it vatma patam graham andapupam varam kato yat dehim ashrayata. That it's an embarrassment. Oh, first of all, he addressed his father as the lord of the demons. Because an atheist always needs to be flattered. The symptom of an atheist is his pride, his uncheckable pride. It's the antithesis of the humble devotee. And we see the example of Prahlad himself, with all humility, was challenging his father in this way, but in a humble manner. But still he was flattering his demoniac father, calling him the king of all demons, this great person, his father. But still he was saying that the jiva in this world who has fallen into this anantha rupa,
one of our great
परम आरतम कृष्ण नित्य लीला कृष्ण विष्णुवाद सदुषण भक्ति वेदांत बामन गोस्वामी महाराज श्री चरण संजय हमार अनंत निशन दान की निवेदन तत्पश्चात मधुर शिक्षा गुरुपात्म अभिन्न गुरुपात्म ओम विष्णुवाद सदुषण भक्ति वेदांत नारायण गोस्वामी महाराज श्री चरण संजय हमार अनंत प्रणति निवेदन तत्पश्चात पूजनीय त्रिवेणी पार्षदे श्री चरण कमले हमार धन्यवाद निवेदन कर समस्त भक्त मंडली श्रद्धालु श्रोतृंद सबाई के धन्यवाद प्रणति निवेदन कर आज हमारे बड़े शुभ दिन शास्त्रे जी बोले साधु संगे কৃষ্ণ এইমাত্র চাই সংসার জিনিসে আর অন্য বস্তু নেই সুতরাং আমরা সাধু সঙ্গে হরিকথা শ্রবণ করছি আমাদের যে আলোচ্য বিষয় এটা কিন্তু সাধারণ শব্দ নয় এটাকে বলছি শব্দ ব্রহ্ম আমরা এই শব্দ ব্রহ্ম সম্বন্ধে একটুখানি অবগত হই এই প্রাকৃত জগতের যে শব্দ ও দ্বারা আমাদের এই জগতের কিছু ভালো মন্দ আমরা বুঝতে পারি কিন্তু এই যে বর্তমান যে সমস্ত আলোচনা আছে এটা হচ্ছে শব্দ ব্রহ্ম সুতরাং এর দ্বারা আমাদের পরম কল্যাণ হবে অথবা আমাদের সমস্ত অনর্থ দূরীভূত হয়ে আমরা ভক্তি লাভ করতে পারব এই জন্য এটাকে মনে করবেন না শুধু হিন্দি বলছি শুধু ইংরেজি বলছি আমরা তো কিছুই বুঝতে পারছি না আর এই শাস্ত্রের যে কথাটি কতবার শোনা যায় এটা কিন্তু নয় আমাদের যেমন শব্দ ব্রহ্ম অর্থাৎ ধরুন একটা ঔষধ বাঙালির দোকান থেকে নিলেও যা কাজ দেবে যারা হিন্দি ভাষী তাদের দোকান থেকে নিলেও যা কাজ দেবে আর ইংরেজি ভাষী লোকের দোকান থেকে নিলেও একই কাজ দেবে সুতরাং হিন্দি হচ্ছে আপনার একটুখানি ঘুমিয়ে পড়বেন তা পড়বেন না ইংরেজি হচ্ছে বুঝতে পারো নাই নাই পারো শুনুন তো শুনলেই আমাদের কাজ দেবে সুতরাং ইংরেজিতে বলছি ওটা শুনুন এই জন্যে আমরা ওতে অলসতা কথা আমরা না করে তিনটে ভাষাকে আমরা শ্রবণ করবো কারণ একই তো মেডিসিন এই তো আমাদের লাভ আছে হিন্দি বলুক আর ইংরেজি বলুক যাই বলুক যে কোনো ভাষায় তো এই ভগবত শব্দ কথা শব্দ ব্রহ্মণে আলোচনা আসবে সুতরাং এখানে ঘুমিয়ে পড়বেন না আপনারা আর বলছেন যে এই সিদ্ধান্ত এই পথপথানি শাস্ত্রে এগুলো ভালো লাগে না কিন্তু পথপথানি না হলেও তো চলবে না তো কারণ সিদ্ধান্ত বলিয়া সৃষ্টি না করো অলম সিদ্ধান্ত বলিয়া না করো কি হয়েছে চিত্তে লাগে সুদৃঢ় মানুষ সিদ্ধান্ত যদি আমাদের না থাকে তাহলে একজনে একটা যুক্তি তর্ক দিয়ে আমার যে আমি হরিভজন করতে যাচ্ছি ওরা নষ্ট করে দেবে যদি আমরা এই শাস্ত্র সিদ্ধান্তে যদি পাকা পক্ষ হয়ে থাকি তাহলে হাজার গুন্দা লোক এটা হাজার কথা বললেও আমাকে চলাতে পারবে না এই জন্য শাস্ত্রের সিদ্ধান্ত আমাদের চাই সিদ্ধান্ত মানে ভিত একটা বেদিন তৈরি করতে গেলে যেরকম হয় ভিত চাই মজবুত শব্দ হচ্ছে এই শাস্ত্র সিদ্ধান্ত সুতরাং এই সিদ্ধান্ত কথা একটুখানি তত্ত্ব বিচার তো এই জন্য হয়তো ভালো লাগে না কিন্তু এটা বিশেষ প্রয়োজন আছে আমাদের এই শাস্ত্রে এই জন্য জগতে আমরা সকলেই বলুন যে
Of
Therefore, someone whose senses are not controlled, their mind, their inclination towards devotional service cannot be awoken by their own efforts, by the efforts of others, or by a combination of both. Sometimes we see that people who are not determined to follow devotional service, even the instructions of Gurudev, cannot help them because they are determined not to follow. Gurudev says, even if your Gurudev is Nityananda, but when you don't listen to what he says, what can Nityananda do for you? Therefore, Father, you are just like that. Puna Puna Chavita Chavananam. You are repeatedly chewed, that is what which has already been chewed. Just like when someone chews chewing gum and all the juice is taken out, then they spit it out. Then someone else comes and picks it up and begins chewing it. You can imagine how much nectar is left. Therefore, mature life is just like that. We see people, our mother and father, they become very old, they become so much infirm, so much diseased. At the end of their lives, they've had so much suffering raising their children, at least I know from my parents. And what do they say? Oh, my dear son, please marry. Even though they've had so much suffering, they keep that, try to give that suffering to their own children. They have a good idea, a fun example, like a dog. Especially in India, we see dogs a little bit malnutrition, how do you say, not eating very nicely. Therefore, there was one dog, and he found an old bone. That bone had no nectar in it, it was completely dry. But that dog was chewing it, and that bone was making his gums bleed, and the dog was drinking his own blood, and the dog was making very juicy bone. Then the other 50 dogs in the neighborhood, they saw that dog with a bone, we have no bone, therefore they began chasing him. And as they were chasing him, they were pounding him, the dog was crying, as he was running. And the other 50 dogs, they were also chasing behind him. Then finally the dog, what did he do? He spat the bone, boom. Then the next dog, the hairless wonder, he took the bone and he began running. Then the 49 dogs began chasing behind him. Therefore Buddha said, this is Puna Puna Chavita Chavananam. Chewing a chew. Even though we see our forefathers, my parents, my grandparents, their parents, they have completely tasted mature life, but they have not received any happiness at all. And finally, at the end of their life, they spit, meaning they leave their body, and they give the same instructions to their children which they have done. They have not been happy accumulating wealth, women, children, house and home. How will the children be happy if they also follow that thing? Therefore, Prabhupada gave some very strong instructions. Therefore, the most important thing, unless we take shelter of a pure devotee, then how pure devotion will ever come in our mind? Is it bhakti from jatya bhakti? It means Prabhupada says, bhakti only comes from bhakti. Therefore, where do we find bhakti in this world? Bhakti and his chanting
philosophy. It's a totally wrong philosophy. You should eat, drink, be merry, enjoy yourself. You don't know when you'll die. You believe in life after death, don't be a fool. But I'm crazy. Be careful, boy.
Do I have to sit in his lap?
Yeah.